Welcome to JSS Matriculation School, Talavadi Social Class. Today I go to explain you Geography Lesson Number 2, Lithosphere 2 Exogenetic Process. Continue part. In the past class, I explain you weather and gradations. Today, I go to explain you erosional landform of underground water. Continue part. In the types of underground water, the first one is terra rosa. It means Italian term for red soil. Depositions of red clay soil on the surface of the earth is due to the dissolutions of limestone content in rocks. The redness of the soil is due to the presence of iron oxide. The second one of that underground water is lapis. When the joints of limestone rocks are corrugated by groundwater, long furrow are formed and these are called lapis. The third one is sink hole. A funnel shaped depression formed due to the dissolutions of limestone rock is called sink holes. What are the show in the picture in the right side of your slides? That's one. Then average depth ranges between 3 to 9 meters. Do you know the world deepest sinkhole in China's Jiangxi Tenskang at 2172 feet? There are as many as 15,000 sinkholes in Illinois. The next one is fourth one, caves and caverns. Caves and caverns are subterranean features of crusta topography. Caves are hollow, then are formed by the dissolution of limestone rocks when carbon dioxide in air turns into carbonic acids after its reaction with water. They vary in size and shape. Caverns are the caves with irregular floor. Example, Guptandam caves in western Bihar. All types of deposits in the caves and caverns are collectively called spilotherms and includes travelines, tufa, dripstones, shallow holes, huvalas, jolinas, polges are the other erosional features of crustal regions, predominant in other parts of the world. We are going to learn about these parts in 10th standard in details. Next, we are going to explain you depositional landforms of underground water. It is the interesting to know that a variety of depositional features are formed on the floor, ceiling and walls of the caves and caverns of the crusta topographies. The first one of that one is stalactite, stalagmite and colmo. When the water containing dissolved calcite gradually drips from the ceiling of the caves, water evaporates and the remaining calcite hangs off the ceiling. Thus, stalactites are formed when the calcite deposit rises upwards like a pillar. Stalagmites are formed. Sometimes stalactites and stalagmites meet together to form columns or pillars. What are the pictures we've been showing in the right side? That one. Next, we are going to explain you glaceries. A glaceries is a large masses of ice that moves slowly over the land from its place of accumulation. It is also known as river of ice. The place of accumulation is called snowfield. The height above which there is a permanent snow cover in the higher altitude of latitude is called snow line. Higher the latitude, lower the snow line from sea level. The gradual transpirations of snow into granular ice is called frin or new, and finally it becomes solid glacial ice. Next, we are going to explain you erosional landform of glaciers. Glaciers are powerful erosive agents. Some of the important erosional landforms are Circuit, Arcites, Matterhorn, U-shaped Valley, Hanging Valley, and Fjords, etc. Most of these glacial features are predominantly seen in countries like Switzerland, Norway, etc. First one of the erosional landform of glaciers is Circuit. The glaciers erodes the step side wall from the mountain and forms a bowl shaped armchair like depressions. It is termed as Circuit. The second one is Arcites, or narrow ridges formed when two Circuit walls join together back to back and forms narrow knife like ridges. The third one is pyramidal peak. We are called that the pyramidal peaks formed when three or more circuits meet together. Example, Matterhorn. Next is U-shaped valley. So what are the pictures I want to give you in the right side? That's all things are explained you, Circuit, Arcites, and Pyramid Peak and U-shaped Valley. When the glaciers move down along a river valley, the valley further gets eroded deep and wide to form a U-shaped Valley. Next is fifth one, Hanging Valley. These are valleys eroded by tributaries, glaciers, and the hangs over the main valley will be there now. So Fjords we are going to now. So Fjords are glacial valley that are partly submerged in the sea. Thank you.